I'll be showing you some simple model fitting and regression techniques in MATLAB in this screencast. What I'm first going to do is show you how you can import some data from Excel into MATLAB, and we're going to use that data in model fitting and regression techniques in MATLAB. I've got some data in a file called bacteria, and this is data showing the optical density of a culture of bacteria as a function of time. You'll notice for each of these times I have in triplicate. Back in MATLAB, I can go up here to the workspace and I can click Import Data, and I will navigate to where my file is. I'm going to open that, and then you can see it's highlighted the data. It's not highlighting the title, which is what I want, and so I can check this to make sure that that's what I want to import. I can go up here to Import, and you'll see that it imported this untitled, and I can double click there to rename it. So I've renamed this data. If you want, you can actually save this. So I'm going to go up here to save. I'll click on that, and I can save this to the folder that I want it to be in. At a later time point, if I want to reload that data, I can just do load data, and assuming I'm in the right folder, then it will actually load it, and it'll put that array over here in the workspace. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to plot this. So I'm plotting data, all rows of column 1, and the response is all rows of column 2. And I'm plotting these points as black squares and putting the grid on. So this is our plot. I've got time on the x-axis, optical density on the left, and you can see that for each of these measurement times, I've got three different measurements of the bacteria culture. So what I'm ultimately trying to do is develop a model equation that models the growth of these bacterial cells. One way to do this is to fit all those different data points to different polynomials, first defining x as our time, y as the response, and here I've got p1, it's a vector which is the polyfit of our data, a first order polynomial, so just a line. I'm creating an actual function that's taking those coefficients of our fit and putting it into polyval, so this would actually be a line so that we can plot that. I'm doing second order polynomial, third order polynomial, and then this fourth one is actually a logarithmic fit. So to do this using polyfit, you actually just take the polyfit of the log of y, and that will give us the equation of a logarithmic fit. I am then computing the residuals. I have residuals 1, which is the residuals between our first order polynomial, or our line, and the actual values. I have the second order, third, and then we have our logarithmic residuals. I'm next plotting a figure. I've got subplots of all the different fits, so the first, second, and third order, and then the logarithmic. But now I'm going to run this file. So when I type bacteria, that's the name of that M script that I showed all the plotting commands in. When I run this, it spits out two figures. The first one is a figure of all the model fits. So I have the first order, that's the line, second order, third order, and then our logarithmic fit. The second plot are the residuals for each of the fits. Again, the residuals are the difference between the model and our actual experimental data points. You can see it's a quadratic function, which means that that's not a very good fit. We have our second order residuals. Those look pretty good. They're somewhat random. I'd say our second and third are pretty similar. And then we have our logarithmic fit. Bacteria actually grow exponentially, so logarithmic should be the best fit. But these cells are actually in something known as the lag phase. So this is one way that we can plot our different fits and then analyze to see how good of a fit each of those models is. So now I'm going to show you how to do these model fits and regression in MATLAB. If you go up here to Tools in the figure and go down here to Basic Fitting, you can choose all sorts of different fits. So I can choose a linear fit, and you see that that is placed onto the plot. I can put a quadratic, a cubic in there. If you want, you can plot the residuals. It's actually going to tell me that I can't use the bar plot residuals if I have replicates, so I'm going to do scatter plot. We look down here, this is a residual plot for all our different fits. I'm actually going to remove my linear, so I have two fits here, the quadratic and the cubic. If I want, I can expand this by clicking on this right arrow, and I can get the coefficients for these fits. So here I have the cubic fit. If I want to look at a quadratic fit, I can do that, and these are the equations, and on the top here it has the form of that equation. If I want to put in here a cubic fit, and then I can click on the right arrow here, it'll actually allow you to interpolate between points. So if I wanted to calculate, let's say, a time of 150 based upon the cubic model, and I can evaluate, I can also plot that if I want, and it goes back here onto the figure. And then if you want to, you can save all those to the workspace. With the data fitting tool that I just showed you, you are somewhat limited to the types of models that you can use. You have to basically go with some of the models that are already built in. Fortunately, there is a curve fitting tool that's built into MATLAB, and you can actually create custom models. So let's do this in MATLAB. I've imported a viscosity Excel file. So this is the viscosity of a fluid as a function of the temperature. So I'm going to just import this, rename it viscosity, and then I've extracted the first column, and that's my X values. The second column is my Y values. And now if I open up this CF tool, which is curve fitting tool, it brings up this window, and I can do a lot of things here. I can bring in my X data, so my Y data, and using this, I can go over here and I can change the different type of model. Here I'm going to do a polynomial. So this is a first degree, which is just a line. I can go over here, I can see the goodness of fit, so a lot of statistical parameters here. We want to maximize adjusted R squared, so I could go here and look at 2. And you'll also notice down here I have the different parameters. I can go to 3, for example, and I can basically go through a bunch of different models to see which one gives me the best adjusted R squared. Now I've put in a custom equation, and we see that I've created a pretty good model here. Just with these three terms, the adjusted R squared is about 0.9972. So you can play around with a bunch of these to determine the best fit for your data. This curve fitting tool can also work with multilinear models. So that means you have two regressor variables such as X1 and X2. You just have two independent regressors and one output, either Y or Z. You can have a second order polynomial. Unfortunately, the curve fitting tool just by itself isn't capable of these interaction terms, which would be like an x1 times an x2 or an x times y, but you can easily put in a custom tool into the curve fitting tool. So here I've got some multilinear data. In column A, I have the response, which is we're going to say is z, and then I've got two regressor variables x and y, and I'm going to import this and I'm going to rename, and then I'm extracting my z values. That's the first column of our data. The X values is the second column, and the Y values is the third column. Now if I type in CF tool, that brings up the curve fitting tool, and I brought in my X, my Y, and my Z, and this time you can actually play around with this three-dimensional plot to see how well that curve, and right now I've got a polynomial with degree 1 for each of those, so the equation is over here on the left. If I want, I can name this fit, and it'll actually store it down here as first order. I can create a new fit, and I've adjusted the order of 2 for both X and Y, and I can save that, and I can compare the two at the bottom. Finally, if I want to do the interaction, which was the third one I showed on that slide, I can go here to custom. So I've created a new fit here, custom brought XYZ. Now I have AX squared plus BY squared plus CXY, so this CXY is the interaction multiplying those two that you can't do with the typical fit. And I look down here, I can rotate this and see that's actually not as good of a fit, and looking down here at the adjusted R squared, that's actually not as good of a fit as the second order. So the second order, the one shown here, actually fits the data very nicely.